Hello, Class 8 students. We are going ahead with Chapter 2, Microorganisms, Friends and Foe. I'm your science teacher with a new topic. Today's topic is malaria. This is a protozoan disease. Before we start learning about malaria as a disease, let us know about the objectives of today's lesson. We have two objectives. First, this lesson will explain how a person is infected with malaria. And this lesson will also discuss the prevention measures for malaria. Our learning outcome at the end of the lesson would be, you as students should be able to spread information about malarial infection, and you should be able to organize malaria prevention awareness campaign in your locality through pamphlets, posters, hoardings, and WhatsApp group shares. Now, when we talk about malaria, a very important but huge question comes up, and the question is, how does a person get infected with malaria? Today we are going to learn about two different aspects of infection. One is how mosquito transmission cycle occurs, and the other is other than the mosquito, how the infection spreads. First of all, let us learn about mosquito transmission cycle. That means how mosquitoes spread malarial infection. We know that malarial parasite is transmitted by a vector known as female Anopheles mosquito, and that is why we call it a mosquito transmission cycle. Let us start learning about this cycle. Malarial infection, as you can see the diagram here, the first point is uninfected mosquito bite and then transmission of parasite, then the development of the parasite in the liver, then the parasite goes to the bloodstream, and then when the infected person is bitten by female Anopheles mosquito, then the infection spreads when the same female Anopheles mosquito bites a healthy individual. But what happens in this cycle? Let us learn in detail. Malarial infection begins when an infected female Anopheles mosquito bites a person, injecting Plasmodium parasites in the form of sporozoites into the bloodstream. You can see here, I have mentioned this particular stage of parasite, which is known as sporozoid stage. So malaria infection begins when an infected female Anopheles mosquito bites a person, injecting Plasmodium parasites in the form of sporozoites into the bloodstream. The sporozoites pass quickly into the human liver. The sporozoites multiply asexually in the liver cells over the next 7 to 10 days, causing no symptoms. In an animal model, the parasites in the form of merozoites are released from the liver cells in vesicles, journey through the heart and arrive in the lungs, where they settle within lung capillaries. The vesicles eventually disintegrate, freeing the merozoites to enter the blood phase of their development. In the bloodstream, the merozoites invade red blood cells and multiply again until the cell burst. Then they invade more red blood cells. This cycle is repeated, causing fever each time parasites break free and invade blood cells. Some of the infected blood cells leave the cycle of asexual multiplication. Instead of replicating, the merozoites in these cells develop into sexual forms of parasite or gametocytes. And these gametocytes keep on circulating in the bloodstream. When a mosquito bites an infected human, it ingests the gametocytes, which develop further into mature sex cells called gametes. The fertilized female gametes develop into actively moving oocinids that burrow through the mosquito's midgut wall and form oocysts on the exterior surface. Inside the oocyst, thousands of active sporozoites develop. The oocyst eventually bursts, releasing sporozoites into the body cavity that travel to the mosquito salivary glands. The cycle of the human infection begins again when the mosquito bites another person. This is how the mosquito transmission cycle of malaria happens. Therefore, we need to take precautions from getting bitten by the female Anopheles mosquito that carries the malarial parasite Plasmodium. But apart from this disease getting transmitted by mosquitoes, what are the other modes of transmission? There are three other modes. One is from mother to a child. If a mother is carrying the malarial parasite, then she can transfer these parasites to the child's body. Then through blood transfusions and by sharing needles used to inject drugs. Now today we have come to know about how the malarial infection spreads from infected people to healthy individuals. Because now you have an idea about the transmission of malarial parasite, the spreading of the infection, then I hope you are in a position to create awareness in your neighborhood, in your locality, in your village, in your school campus about how to adopt some methods so that people get prevented from getting infected with malaria. So here I have prepared two topics for you as project 1 and project 2. You have to either go for project 1 or you can go for project 2. It is your choice. So your first project is to create pamphlets to create awareness on malaria prevention at home and in neighborhood. And project 2 is you have to conduct a small survey in your village on how many people actually use mosquito nets on windows and doors to prevent entry of mosquitoes and other insects into their houses. What you have to do is you have to count the number of houses in your locality or your village, then how many doors and windows each house have, and then the number of family members in each house, incidence of malaria in each family, and how many houses have removable nets, either cloth nets or iron nets on their windows and doors for malaria prevention. This will show whether the people in your neighborhood are really careful about malaria ill infection or not. So to conclude the presentation, I'd like to say that all of you stay safe, stay healthy, because we know that prevention is better than cure. Therefore, we need to take care on preventing ourselves from getting bitten by female Anopheles mosquito. Thank you.